but as he never went on to describe such a trip, it seems reasonable to assume any such invitation did not in the end lead to a visit. Morris may have been discreet in terms of not disclosing the content of private conversations, but he was perfectly open about the contacts he had that were in the public domain. That he could relate any kind of friendship with Kennedy to a churchyard in Derbyshire was exactly the sort of link Oldfield not only liked to exploit, but was happy to discuss. It was another example of his bringing things down to the most basic level. Oldfield still needed to build a relationship with Dick Helms, then a deputy director of Central Intelligence, who was to be elevated to the top job under President Lyndon Johnson. Helms had been heavily involved in Project MKUltra to develop truth serums and other supposedly mind-altering drugs in the hope of weeding out moles and traitors. He was in the vanguard of the paranoia that had permeated American intelligence services, and one of the most highly favoured weapons in his armoury was the polygraph, or lie detector, something he tried to foist on MI6. Even though the obvious response to Helms's insistence would have been to consent to the suggestion in the hope of building the confidence of the CIA, Morris Oldfield was steadfast in his scepticism about the effectiveness of the polygraph. He was known to be enthusiastic about technological advances that could assist his officers in their work, and in particular those gadgets that made this work safer, but not at all costs. He was, as ever, using what he described as overhadden common sense, careful to be aware of the limitations and potential failings of emerging technology. In the case of the polygraph, Oldfield's line was that it was an easy way out for any scoundrel. And he urged the CIA to temper its inclination to rely on lie detector results with little, if any, question. He was aware that the KGB had a training section devoted to coaching its agents in how to beat the polygraph and how to lie in general, and encouraged the Americans to devote their energies towards learning the techniques involved. These were known to include controlled breathing, artificially raising the heart rate prior to the test, and using hidden implements to self-inflict pain at key points in the questioning to try and vary the readings.